We're given this data and we're asked to calculate the sidereal period of the moon. That is the time that it takes the moon to go around the Earth one time. So we're given the mass of the moon, the mass of the Earth, the distance from the Earth to the moon, and we're told to approximate the orbit as circular, which is not a terrible approximation. So we want to calculate the period, so we can use Kepler's third law. We can say that t squared is equal to 4 pi squared divided by g times the mass of the central object. The central object here will be the Earth, right? Because the moon is going around the Earth for all intents and purposes. They're actually orbiting the center of mass of the Earth-Moon system, but because the Earth is about 81 times more massive than the moon, we can approximate the central object as the Earth itself, okay? And then multiply times the distance between them squared. So this is, or cubed rather, so this is just, we can put a d here. Okay, so substituting in 4 pi squared, I'm going to leave these down here as letters, g, this is the mass of the Earth that goes in here, 5.98 times 10 to the 24, and then times d cubed, that will be the Earth-Moon distance, 3.82 times 10 to the 8th. And then all of that is cubed, okay? So this is t squared. And then t, the period, is equal to 2.3489 times 10 to the 6th seconds. We convert that to days, and we will achieve 27.2 days. Okay, so Wiki has this as 29.5 days, right? The Britannica has it as a different number. NASA had it at 27.3 days. Okay, and so there are different methods for calculating this. I think the average, the actual measured is, you know, on the order of 27.3, so we're in the general region here, in general area. But Wiki is sort of outside the fold, so use, you know, you want to check your sources against one another, you know, make sure you use vetted sources, so on and so forth. See you next time.